Good morning. My name is Spiros Dimitrelis. I'm the director of Capital.gr. And we have the honor today here at Delphi Economic Forum to welcome Mr. Andrea Enria, who is the chair of the supervisory board of the European Central Bank. Welcome, Mr. Enria, to the forum.
Hello, good morning. Good morning, everybody.
Because our time is very limited, let's start immediately with the interview. Mr. Enria, what is your general assessment of the situation of the Greek banking system?
Well, the Greek banks have achieved a significant reduction in the level of non-performing loans in the last years, and what is positive is that they continued to clean up their balance sheets also during the pandemic, in 2020 and beginning of 2021. Since the start of the banking union in 2016, NPLs from those of the banks have been down 50% of around 68 billion. So there has been a significant reduction in the stock. But the level of the so-called NPL ratio, so the ratio of non-performing loans to total loans, remains the highest in the banking union. The Hercules Asset Protection Scheme has been very effective in pushing forward the cleaning up of the bank's balance sheet and accelerating the process. There have been important transactions already completed, and more in the pipelines with the Hercules II program. I think that if I remember well, there are around 40 billion of deals which are in the pipeline for the coming year. So, on my side, I can only encourage the Greek banks to continue with the good progress in this direction, because the completion of the of addressing the legacy issues from past crises, I think, is the most important element to make the system in a position to support effectively the Greek economy after the pandemic. Like other banks in the euro area, the challenge now is especially to look through the measures, the support measures, through the moratoria, through the fiscal support measures, and properly assess credit risk and ensure that distressed customers are managed promptly and effectively. And so far, the payment behavior following the expired moratoria has been positive, so payments have resumed regularly, and there has been a lower than expected number of restructuring necessary. However, let's say it's too early to declare victory, so we are not yet at the end of the crisis, and we need to be very cautious.
Too early, well, to declare victory. This is very interesting. Let's go now, Mr. Enria, to the level of the corporate governance of the Greek banks. Are you satisfied with the level of the corporate governance in Greek banks?
Let me start from the European picture. Governance, internal governance, has been one of the key areas of attention for the ECB as a supervisor. This is the area where we have most findings in our supervisory processes, and where we are asking remediation measures to most banks across the banking union. Greek banks have materially improved their governance in the last years. There has been a general overhaul in 2016 when the HFSF law, the Hellenic Financial Stability Fund law, was issued, and bank boards were broadly renewed. But there are still steps to be done, of course, to bring the system, the sector, not only in Greece, I must say, in general, in line with the best international practices. And we are also, advancing our policies in this area. We will soon issue a new guide for consultation on fit and proper assessment that will be much, you know, more European, integrated European level, and much also stronger in terms of the checks that we will make for individual members of banks board to ensure the good quality to all the people who have been involved in the past in conduct issues or banks which have been subject to fines and the like, so that there is proper follow-up and that we are sure that we have strong boards able to drive banks in an effective way.
Mr. Noria, there is a lot of controversy here in Greece about the way that the NPLs will be solved. It's already in place the Hercules schemes, but there are also proposals for the creation of, of an asset management company. Do you think that an asset management company will be inevitable, will be necessary to solve the problem of the NPLs?
Well, let me start by saying that the experience of the last 10 years is that when we do have material problems of asset quality, public policy support measures are important to accelerate the cleaning of the bank's balance sheets. There have been different tools which have been developed. Government guarantees on securitization have been an effective tool. Asset management companies also have been effective. I personally have always advocated European solutions, and I would have liked to have European schemes. For the moment, this is not on the table, and national governments have to choose the avenues they prefer. In Greece, as you mentioned, Hercules, so a government guarantees on securitization, which has been modeled around the Italian GACS, the Italian scheme, has been very effective so far and has worked very well. So that's something which is to be underlined. Asset management company also have worked effectively, and they could also be complementary tools. In Italy, for instance, the GAC scheme has been complemented by an asset management company, AMCO, which recently has also helped banks in a number of cases with significant transactions. The two tools can be complementary and can be considered together also.
Let's go now to the capitalization of the Greek banks. Do you think that Greek banks are sufficiently capitalized?
Well, there have been positive developments recently. Greek banks have come back to the market, issuing let's say instruments which are eligible as regulatory capital. So there's been an important issuance of equity. There have been issuances of additional tier 1 and tier 2 instruments. So there has been an important reopening of the market, and with most of the issuances which have been significantly oversubscribed. So also from the investor side, there has been an important sign of attention for Greek banks. That's positive. And it creates room for banks to explore this possibility to take all the asset quality issues in an even bolder fashion in a faster time. So I think that's an important opportunity for the banks to move ahead.
Let me ask you now, if you believe that Greek banks are ready to do their part in the recovery of the Greek economy after the pandemic. Are they ready?
The pandemic has been addressed with an extraordinary suite of policy support measures, which have been fiscal policy measures, monetary policy measures, and supervisory measures as well. And there have been moratoria, government guarantees, other fiscal support measures, extraordinary support from the monetary policy side in terms of liquidity, which has compressed also spreads in most sovereigns, and as supervisors we create capital space for the banks. This has been a strong action coordinated at the European level, very unified, which has created the condition for banks to continue lending to households, small and medium enterprises, and corporates. And across Europe and in Greece as well, banks have expanded their lending to the economy. In Greece, there has been a growth in loans to non-financial corporates, very substantial. At the end of 2020, it was 10% growth, and which was confirmed in the first quarter of 2021. So growth rates never experienced since the great financial crisis started in 2008. So lending is increasing, and the support to the economy is there. Of course, the increase in lending is not in itself enough. No, I mean, you need good lending. So it is if the increase in lending after a while materializes into non-performing loans, then you've got a problem. Then you would clog the ability of the banks to support the economy exactly when the fiscal packages of next generation EU will become available. And it is important that we will maintain a good interaction of private support from the banks of the economy and the fiscal support from the European packages. That's why we put so much attention to the ability of banks to manage credit risk effectively and identify and manage promptly customers which are not in good shape and not able to repay their loans. Credit risk management at this moment is crucial.
Mr. Andrea, has the coronavirus crisis made us wiser in supervising the banks or in the monetary policy?
The crisis is not yet over, so it's maybe too early to draw lessons. Still, there are a few points which I think are good lessons so far. First, having a banking sector which is well capitalized is essential to withstand a shock, even of the dimension of the coronavirus shock. I mean, let's remind ourselves, it's the harshest recession on record in European peacetime history. So, and the banking sector was still able to react positively. So, having sometimes it is said also the banking industry that the high capital requirements are a problem for growth. And actually, what we have seen is that good capital positions are essential to withstand shocks and continue financing the economy. So I think there is good value in that. The second point I would highlight is that the prompt and very integrated European solutions, European policy actions are also very important. It's the first time that we had a crisis in the banking union. So joined up, integrated supervisory response, full, fast response from monetary policy, and also integrated European response from the fiscal point of view, which has been a first, in a sense, in our system. I think that's also very important. Maybe the other point on which we need to think further is the impact on digitalization. The pandemic has led to a stepwise significant increase in the reliance on digitalization, also the provision of banking services. And this is a challenge for banks, this is a challenge also for us as supervisors. And we need to see precisely which lessons to draw from that.
Mr. Ria, my last question, because it's very recent developments. We have seen in the capital markets the last days that the interest rates of the Eurozone government bonds are rising slightly. The analysis behind this is that markets are afraid of inflation, That's why they're picking up the interest rates. Do you worry about those analysis, those dangers? Are we going to have inflation after the COVID-19 pandemic?
But inflation, as you know, is the key issue for my colleagues on the other building of the ECB, so on the central banking side of the ECB. As a supervisor,
as an economist, I'm asking, yes.
Banks have been, to an extent, expecting and looking positively to a possible increase in interest rates because the low and negative interest rates environment so far has exercised quite a compression on their interest margins. But I think that a sudden, unexpected increase in yields or, let's say, steepening of the yield curve can also generate significant risks to stability in the banking sector. We have, especially in the last years, we've seen an increase in high leverage finance, for instance, both of which we as supervisors have put a lot of attention. And we see recently cases like the default of this Archegos fund, which was an overrated bank entity, highly leveraged and high concentrated exposures. So I think we need to look quite carefully into the risk that can come from the highly leveraged segment of our financial markets. And let's carefully look at the risk that can come from that in case there were unexpected increases in the steepness of the yield curve.
Okay, Mr. Nouria, what is your message for the Greek, as a last question, what is your message for the Greek consumers, for the Greek entrepreneurs, for the next day of the pandemic? Should they be positive and optimistic about a real fast recovery of the Greek economy financed by the Greek banks?
I think that let's say that there is room for optimism. The projections of the European Central Bank are pointing to a strong rebound of our economy, bringing it to the pre-crisis level in 2022. Still, let's say again, the recovery might be unequal this time. The support measures are particularly targeting certain sectors, certain initiatives. So there might be a Schumpeterian moment, as economists call it. So the moment in which we push innovation, we have a rebound in the digital economy, in the green economy. But there might be also sectors that maybe could not come back with the same strength they had before the crisis. So there could be differences in the way in which our economy rebounds, and I think it is important that the banking sector is strong enough to support the recovery and to perform its traditional function of allocating funds and managing actively credit risk in what will still be a difficult year ahead of us.
Well, Mr. Andrea, thank you very much for your enlightening opinion about the Greek and the European banking sector and economy. It was an honor for us to have you here at the Delphi Economic Forum. So thank you, and hoping to have you soon here again.
Thank you very much for having invited me. I was supposed to be there in person last year. We managed due to the pandemic. At least this year we managed in a digital format, but I hope in the future it will be possible to come to Delphi. Thank you very much, and have a good talk.
Thank you. Thank you.